So I suppose it's the 21st day. Day 21. Yes, day 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, day 35. Day 30, sorry. Yes, roughly day 30 that I live without a dad and Jesus. God forbid if I don't, if that really did some damage upon me. And most importantly is to make the matters worse, I don't actually have that many people to talk about that, and you know, even not known from, you know, from my WeChat contact list, and known whom I can share such burden with from, you know, on Facebook. Well, not exactly, because you know, they pretty much don't return my voice calls or phone calls or whatsoever. And just a couple of hours ago, I tried to ring, you know, a what is it called? Yes, it's actually, yes, evangelism response center, and all I heard was some sort of you know, some sort of voice that resembled that very much resembled Siri's. So, you know, kind of squandered my phone credit by, you know, by listening to that, to you know, to that somewhat, you know, to that lady who is somewhat similar to Siri for like a couple of minutes, and then I just hung up. And you know, it didn't make me feel any particular, any you know, it didn't particularly make me feel any better. So I still have no idea if I should just, you know, try many attempts to ring them back whatsoever. But you know, another thing that I've you know, I've probably come to realization that the vast majority of people, at first glance, they seem willing to help you, or to provide their assistance with certain things of yours, or with certain affairs of yours. At first glance, for some time, yeah, they all appear so generous, so kind, so friendly. But eventually, they all turn, you know, unhelpful, if not hostile. You know, after some time, after they offer you some sort of help, and they either somehow vanish, or they just stop giving you a damn about whatever thing they use, you know, whatever thing they devoted their kindness to you, to your affairs, temporarily. And you know, that in fact further strengthened my faith in God. Well, I don't know if it has further strengthened my faith in God, or has actually diminished my faith in God, or in pretty much everyone here on earth. You know, I you know what, in fact, I once thought of renaming this you know, the title of this video, you know, I used to want to call it, you know, several ways to make you cry, you know, or something similar to that, you know. But on the contrary, I'm feeling freaking sad and freaking upset, I begin to get this sensation of numbness, you know, pretty much completely numbness, yet very sad, yet very, you know, devastated. But I pretty much forgot, you know, pretty much forgot how to cry, you know. Though it gets, you know, it, you know, I just don't know how to shake this feeling or devastation off instantly. And I've also noticed another simple and rudimentary fact about women is that the vast majority of women, they are pretty much every woman I met pretty much knows how to cry at any moment, at any given moment, in any given situation, better than anyone do, but better than anyone does, you know. So there is certainly a completely different underlying mechanisms that triggered a crying, a tearing response, you know, when it comes to, you know, discerning the gender disparities, the gender differences between men and women. I just never used to get to experience such fact in person, of course, because obviously I never lost a parent, although yes, it depends on how you choose to interpret the meaning of loss. Perhaps yes, this is my second time losing or having lost a parent, because my biological mother pretty much did not give a damn about me. But just non-stop abusive languages, abusive visits, abusive contemplations whatsoever, not just against me in person, but like I said, I'm sure you watched and listened to several of my previous videos on YouTube, and if you haven't, or if you happen to never watch it before, then I highly recommend you do so, since in so doing you will get a somewhat vague idea about my own background and you know, and whatnot. So basically I just lost the ability to, you know, to discern whom to trust, whom not to trust, you know, after all this chain of events that I've been experiencing. Jesus, mate. Of course, I don't expect people to babysit me all the time, but it is just so heartbreaking to finally realize that even people from church, they don't, in those pastors who always have that, who, you know, who can always manage to, you know, to live seamlessly in their own masks, disguises in front of everyone, you know, he or she is preaching his messages to. Despite all those disguises and masks, I know better that they might just have more problems than the vast majority of you guys there who are watching and listening to my videos. And probably yes, I don't actually quite envy them, because we'd never know the truths unless we get to experience all those processes, those agony, excruciating agony in person ourselves. And you know, fair enough, we just don't earn or we just haven't earned that credit, or that we earn no place nor credit to judge people that rashly, that casually, you know, because we never know the things that occurred behind the scene without having to experience them on our own during our own time. So, you know, there's one more thing that I feel quite shit about, is that I just didn't give good care to my old man, you know, and I certainly, you know, despised him for quite a multitude of times for the frugal, you know, styles of living on many occasions. And of course, you just don't judge how much you love a particular someone by whatever things you try to do, you know, after his death, or, you know, but instead we judge how much we love a particular someone by the things we did, you know, the effort, the time we invested on that particular someone while he or she was still alive. And what, you know, and those, you know, hypocrisies here, especially in China, you know, there are quite a number of customs and traditions to follow, you know, once, you know, several days before the funeral, or you know, several days after the funeral, and I didn't comply with them at all, except I had to, you know, I just, you know, for my grandmother's sake, I just had to, you know, make certain compromises. So, you know, I just, Jesus, I just don't even know why I did that, you know, either for my grandma's sake or whatsoever, you know. I just, all I can recall was I just got sick of, you know, rejecting someone. I just got sick of rejections, and I probably displayed some moments of weaknesses, some moments of vulnerabilities towards the people I care about. So in short, I just didn't want to disappoint them or make them feel even worse by my hardwired disposition towards non-compliance with my grandma's and my old man's instructions. Yes, Jesus, I just don't know if there are any more. Meaningful things I can talk about in regards to my old man's death, and all those shit I've been through. Don't worry. I'm not gonna kill myself for that, because I have been feeling suicidal long before my old man's death, though I still haven't managed to gather that much or that high level of strength or courage to make that a reality, to actualize it. Not in the next couple of years. I will certainly try my utmost best to hold the line, to endure to the end. And I don't know, despite not knowing what God, why God has sent me to this shitty world, for whatever reasons, for whatever purposes, probably I can give you some vague and highly ambiguous answers, blended with some of my wild speculations about why God sent me to this world exactly. But when I feel like it, I shall let you guys know letting you guys know. What else? Please excuse me. Okay. Maybe I should file a report to the local police. And see how that turns out. But I seriously doubt if they could do anything about it, because on most occasions the local Chinese police, they tend to consider such matter as a civil matter instead of a criminal report, a criminal affair. So my best guess is that sooner or later I just have to depart China to some other countries like Japan, Iceland. Yes, well I suppose I can my current financial capability should do more than just sufficing me to become self-sufficient in Japan. Not in cities like Tokyo, Osaka, or Kobe, but probably yes, I do stand a chance, by long shot in Fukuoka, in Sapporo, in you know, probably also in Kyoto. One way or another, now I really have to start considering my escape route to Japan, and start making selections on which air ticket I should purchase, and buy my, get a JR pass for 14 days or for 21 days or whatsoever. So in case you guys have some time to spare, please let me know anything you know about how to get a JR pass for 15 days, since that's the time frame I plan to stay in Japan for. And it's my, in truth, it's my second time paying my visit to Japan, so I certainly have a lot of catch up to do. When it comes to making plans about, making trips to Japan. So please let me know what you think, or what you say about such matter below this video clip. And once again, thank you very much for taking the time listening to and watching my videos. I certainly need to express my gratitude towards anyone, towards everyone who's been watching and who's been supporting me by watching my videos, by posting your comments and feedbacks below all my videos. So thank you again. Thank you very much again, minasama. Domo arigato. Domo nagai aida arigato gozaimashita. Arigato gozaimasu. And mata kondo, YouTube de. Bye bye. Jan. Stay tuned. Stay blessed. Stay faithful.